And we are live. Welcome to 3-9 Sports to your second season draft. I'll be your host tonight, ACDC. I'm filling in for the incomparable Mr. Hollywood, never to be replaced or copied, but I'll do my best to fill in for him while I'm taking the show on in his absence. We have probably a first for this league and for a lot of leagues. We're going to have three of the captains draft live, which should be really interesting, which will cause, I'm sure, some smack talk, some back and forth between the captains, which is always good, which is what we love about this league. Joining me on this podcast, we have 37 in a row. Daly, one of the captains, which I spoke of.
Yes, sir.
The always famous and infamous Mr. Yambag, also a captain. And DJ, my man, the one I want to see do well in this draft.
What's up, boys?
And the man, the myth, the legend, means everything to this league and to e-hockey, Mr. Giant918. Glad to have you all. Go ahead, sir.
www.239hockey.net. Follow us on Twitter at 239hockey. The fact of the matter is, 239 Hockey family, is that this isn't season zero. This isn't season one. This is season two right in front of us, right here. Right now, we got 10 teams over here. Just when we thought there was absolutely no chance of even having a season number two, the Yetis woke up and everybody got together. And look what we have over here at 239 Hockey, where we're making hockey great again. There are these other leagues out there. They might tell you they're better. They spew nothing but a bunch of fake news. And that's all they have to say. We don't even have to mention it anymore, because that's all there is. These guys know where it's at. I know, you know, we all know 239 Hockey has the best online hockey league on the face of the planet. I'm really pumped up for this. I don't know about the rest of you guys. Shout out to all the captains, even to my colleagues over here, to the left of me, to the right of me. Shout out to all the players out there, including the part-time players. We had a bunch of captains last year, including defending captain championship captain D-Mart. So shout out to D-Mart 15. This guy is an absolute winner. He was winning so much. I mean, he was just winning all the time. He just got sick and tired of winning. So he's going to be part-time this season. This is what's going on over here, 239 Hockey family. Exciting time over here. Season two draft. We're ready to rock. How's everybody feeling on this tonight over here? I soldier up. What's going on over there, brother? You pumped up or what for season two draft, bro?
Always, man. You know, a lot of talk about Daly traping me here, and you know, I'm losing my first overall pick and getting a couple middle round picks. But you know, that's all right. I think there's a lot of talent in the middle of the pool here, and I think I'll do all right despite some claims otherwise here.
Yeah, and what's your take? How do you feel about going in the draft?
After the draft's over, everybody's going to be nice and salty.
Daly, I see you have your little one on you, the very cute child. What's your take on going into this draft?
Me and the old dog already know that old dad's winning this year. Everybody knows it. Everybody said it. Don't look at me like that. That means we're going to win. That's how it is. Truth be told. All right, he saw Yambag, and he's like, I'm done with this shit. I'm out.
Peace. Loving the pajamas, though. Those are awesome. I got to get me a pair of those.
Yeah, man. Oh, yeah, the onesie, the Elmo onesie. It's done. So, yeah, we all know. We're ready. We're ready to rip. I've done my research. I've traded DJ. I got Sniper in there. I got everybody, so I'm ready to go. Let's do the bet. Let's get it.
True.
And 37, what's your first take of this draft so far? What do you expect of this draft?
It's going to be interesting. There's a couple of captains that traded out of the first round, one of them being Mr. Daly here. You got Flanny taking two picks in the first round. We got Sniper with two picks in the first round, so it should be interesting. Just excited to see who's going to be number one.
A lot of critical issues over here, AC. DJ, a.k.a. I Soldier Up, we were very critical of you trading your first overall pick over here. And the way it looks like the draft pick is over here, unless some trades happen imminently, looks like your first pick isn't until pick number 17 overall. Do you think anything left other than a bag of dicks is going to be there at 17, DJ?
You know, I think there's a lot of unknown guys here that I think there's a lot of unknown guys here that are really – they've gone unnoticed to a lot of captains. And, you know, if you look at it, I've got two picks in the second. I've got one in the third and two in the fourth. That's a lot of middle ground. You don't need all-stars to win cup games, you know what I mean? It's just I think I'll do all right in the middle rounds. I don't think I need anybody here that's going to stand out as number one, you know. DeMart or someone like Daly was in the draft pool, you know, I'm not taking that – I'm not trading that number one overall pick at all. I'm taking one of those guys. But beyond that, I mean, I think I'll be all right in the middle rounds.
Very cool, very cool. So what is it, AC, exactly that we're waiting for at this particular point in time? Is there a moderator over there in the chat that's ready to start this off, get this party started, or what?
Yeah.
I believe so. I think we got to get them all the captains notified that they're there. Letting people know they're in, and then get the draft going.
So we didn't even do that yet?
We're ready to go.
No, we're ready.
Yeah, we're good here. We're good.
All right.
Oh,
then let's,
man, I got shook from that. I'm like, oh, man, what are we going to talk about?
So let's kick it off then.
Well, we got a pick. Number one overall, Chubbs Reborn.
Wow. Yeah. And Flanny, shout out to Flanny over here. He's my usual co-host and cohort. Unable to make it because he's too into the zone over here, making hockey great again. Number one overall, Yambag. How good of a pick do you think this is, man? I think there are a bunch of other guys that he could have chosen here at number one overall. Is that a good pick or isn't it?
I was going to take him at my pick. So it was a good pick.
Oh, I guess so, man.
Well, he was second in scoring for the league, wasn't he, last year?
Whoa!
Pretty high. What?
Yeah. Oh,
Mags just took Thug. CTC.
Thug for number two, yeah.
Well, that's shout out to McGillis. Shout out to Thug CTC. These guys are primetime players over here at 239 Hockey. Oh, these two guys go back, years. Before I even got married, I knew these two dudes, man. Good dudes, man. I don't know about that pick for number two overall. Mm. 37 in a row. What do you think about that, man? I mean, Thug CPC,
Is
that worthy of a number two overall?
He's a quality goalie. I don't know what else he has set for. I know Mags will probably take a goalie. He'll be playing lefty himself. That's an interesting pick. That is definitely interesting.
Oh, man. Yeah, I don't understand that one.
Jesus Christ.
Thug, you asshole. He's a great player, but, I mean, just again – at number two overall, there's so many names that I'm looking at on this list that and this is not a shot at Thugs. It's more the position he plays. It's just not a value pick there. I would have went a different way myself. But like I said, McGill did a lot of homework, so hopefully he knows what's up. So we'll see what happens.
Well, we have Sober taking Light the Lamp number three, and also Snipers made a pick as well. Any thoughts on Light the Lamp?
Are these guys – is this one of the ringers – that you described, I Soldier Up? Is that what you're seeing over here? I've never heard of this guy unless he's got a different gamer tag.
Light the Lamp, that's one of Daly's boys coming over from one of the other leagues that Daly played in. And I don't know. I don't know much about him. I haven't seen him play before, but that's where it's coming from. Daly can probably explain a little bit better.
I mean, he's a great two-way player. He's probably end up being the best face-off guy in the league. He'll probably be first in that category. I had a lot of struggles trying to match him in another week that I played with him. Honestly, I think he's a great pick at three. Even though he's not really known, he's solid. So I don't hate the pick at all. That means Sober did a little bit of homework and Lamp got some games. And so definitely a solid pick by Sober. A great guy to build around. So I'll be interested to see how Sober plays it. And then Yam takes Annihilator. Yam, go ahead and explain your pick, man.
Well, these other assholes took every fucking guy that I wanted before me. So,
your boyfriend's there.
You could take number one pick overall, Yam.
No, I'm good where I'm at. I got a top 15 in the world center, dude. I'm ready to fucking roll.
We also got to mention Sniper's pick. I apologize if I butcher this gamer tag, but
Stratios, a.k.a. Big Head Steve, a.k.a. was on Yam's team last year. Yam, give the scouting on Stratios.
Who?
Or not.
No, Stratios is really good, man. he's really good with Chubbs, and they're both, you know, Chubbs and Steve, Big Head Steve is a Stratios, and they're both really good in the parties. Like, they don't get emo and fucking, you know, wine and bullshit. So they're good picks. I was going to take one or the other if they were there, so I'm kind of fucking...
Well, I mean, yeah, back, but you say that, but to be fair, were you guys down 10-1 in a game or anything like that? Any kind of blowout like that? There's no mercy rules over here, man. So, I mean, I would get emo in a party. I wouldn't want to talk to anybody. I'd probably have to mute myself because I'd be talking so much trash if we were losing 10-1 and people are playing like a bunch of douchebags, bro.
Now, I think 80% of our losses were by one fucking goal last season. So,
yeah.
You know, and Stratios was part time last season, so that was hard to work with. But when he was in there, he was really good.
So we got a Cujo couple more
picks here. Yep.
Took King Rome, solid pick.
Yeah.
And then Cameron took time to get to Steven, which also very good pick.
And quickly, AKA Drift King. Yeah.
Quickly on Annihilator, I actually ended up playing a couple of games with him and Sober just for fun before this weekend on Thursday night. Super great guy. Really good guy in chat. Really solid defenseman. All around great guy. So that's a good pickup.
Yamp said he was like top 15 center over here. I just
Yeah, my apologies. John completely screwed that up. He was a center. There was another guy in there as well. But both the guys that were playing with Sober were really good chill guys. And really good at the game. So, good picks.
Yeah, I want to give a quick shout-out to Crazy Yeti Killer. He gave me a – I got a message going across my phone over here. I just want to give a shout-out to one of the vets over there, man. A lot of old-time guys, man, that have been here for – have been – we played with for years coming around this time around. He said he wanted to take his skills down to South Beach, bro. You can go over there with D-Wade and LeBron and all them. Yawn. 239's where it's at, man. Southwest Florida, bro. Not South Beach, all right? Get it right, Yeti.
So we have Sabby making a pick. BCO, another good pick.
He's really good. I like him.
Solid pick. You guys surprised goalies aren't going quicker?
No, I'm not. You're looking at it like this. There's a couple full-time. There's a lot of willing. You know, again, with the way this game plays, and, you know, it's tough to change a game from net. You can, but it's tough. You know, I think you're going to see a lot more forwards, stuff like that. It just makes sense. With the way that this game plays, I'm not surprised by it. It's not a shot at the goalies in any sort of way. It's just it's a product of the game and how it's played. Thug going early at 2, I thought was way too early. I'm assuming he's playing that for McGill up. But yeah, man, I'm not shocked that goalies aren't ran out yet. You probably will see a lot of goalies fall the 3rd, 4th, 5th round. I think that's where they're going to go, even the good ones. I know Drift went at 8, but again, there's exceptions to the rules. But for the most part, I think you're going to see these guys go later in the draft, just in my opinion.
Do you think goalies that are captains have an advantage in this draft?
Yeah, someone want to take it because I'm going to make my picks here.
Yeah, you know what? I'm just taking a look at that. You're saying if you take a goalie faster? Ask the question again, please, AC.
Yeah, no, I was asking, are you surprised that you're not seeing goalies getting picked sooner in this draft? I mean, we're only in the first round, but goalies are a shortage. But I think Daly made some really good points about that position may not be a game changer in this game, but it is a position that's hard to find people that are good at it. So – I personally think captains that are goalies have a bit of an advantage, but I think Daly made a great point that you're not going to necessarily burn a high round pick based on the impact a goalie can make versus a really good forward or defenseman.
Yeah, I agree that they're not there's not a lot of them, but there's a lot of willing out there, but there's also a lot of refuse out there too. So I think it's going to be a delicate balance. I think a lot of them will be going in the 3rd round. That's when I personally think a lot of the goalies are going to go. DJ, what are your thoughts on this, man? I mean, is it a good strategy? 2nd, 3rd round? I know you don't want to tip your cap over here and give up your strategy. Take it over here. 2nd round, 3rd round, 4th round. Or,
ideas with that? I mean, I think it's goalies are definitely going to go later. I don't think, like Daly was saying, they're not really a necessity here right off the bat, just as a product of the game. I don't want to give too much away here just because I still got to make my picks. I got a couple mid-round picks, but I think definitely goalies are going to be going on later here.
So we have sniper. We got some picks to catch up on. Sniper pick Marty McFly. That's a good pick, in my opinion. Flanny picks No Cause Renegade. And then Daly picked DeMart. That's a bold move, picking a part-time player first pick.
Yeah, Daly.
I mean, yeah, the thing is, man, is that Dan's a top player in this league. And I'm not going to let a part-time label screw up my draft. That's why I ended up trading out of the first round. I knew I wanted Dan the whole time. I've got some things on my sleeve still with draft picks that I'm going to make to combat the part-time. I primarily want to play defense all year, but if I have to jump up and play forward on those part-time days, I will. I've got a lot of stuff in the works. So Dan's an elite player, and Chew Therapy is a guy that I've played with for a while. They play really well. Will play really well together. I know they're going to mesh as far as styles go, and I know that Yambag's drafting behind me, so I might be taking guys a little bit earlier than I usually would. because Yam is the ultimate cock block. So with that being said, that's why ultimately I took Dan where I did, because I didn't think he'd be available at pick 24, and he probably wouldn't be. So
no, he absolutely would not have been.
I mean, all
right, yeah, and I would say having DeMart even half of the time is a very, very good person to have playing this game. Savvy,
Yeah, I agree, dude.
So we also got Sabby made a pick. He took Hi, My Name Is Ed, longtime vet in many leagues, very solid defenseman, also capable forward when needed to be. Not sure what they're drafting him for, but can play both positions pretty well.
Yeah, I mean the pick over here, listen, I know there's a lot of players still on there, including the part-time players and stuff like that. I don't know if Hi, My Name Is Ed, you stated that correctly, AC, that we have played with him for years. Well-known individual. I don't know about 13th overall, though. That is probably one of the highest picks I've ever seen him being chosen at. Hollywood Bob, now I'm biased. I have played with this dude. He is funny as hell. He might be tripping balls while you're in the party, but he knows how to have a good fucking time when he's playing on the ice and off the ice and while you're in an Xbox Live party. So shout out to Hollywood Bob over there in upstate New York, if he's still living up there, man. Good times over there. I just don't know, once again, if this is number 14 overall pick over here. And I just want to mention something over here to the board of directors of 239 Hockey. Whoever sets up the draft pool, what we used to have over here, we used to have career stats over here. So I know we've had season zero, season one. It's something that the board of directors may want to consider for future drafts so that some sort of stats are up there. Just to remind some of the captains to assist with them and stuff like that, some of the stats over there, points per game, number of games played, things of that nature. You know, when you get towards the end of the later rounds, like the fifth round and the sixth round, when you're trying to fill out the roster completely, it's some kind of information that you might want to have over there. I don't know what you guys think of that. Just throwing out a suggestion over there. Fantastic job over here, whoever has created this, the spreadsheet over here for the draft sheets, because it does include the waivers and the season one draft results and stuff like that. That's just something to consider for the future, AC?
Yeah, no, good points. We got some more draft picks to pick up on here. So Cujo picked, and again, I'm going to butcher this gamer tag. I apologize. Mopar WK.
That's Gunny.
Gunny.
He's a cup-winning defenseman, and he seems to be – I did some checking on some names before I did a little prep work. Seems to be a highly offensive defenseman as well, so that's not a bad pickup, I don't think, for Cujo. And then we have Yam picking Hugh Laurie and DJ picking I'm Still Viper. So we'll let Yam give a little response on his pick, and then DJ, you can tell us why you picked Viper.
I knew you were taking Viper, by the way, DJ. Just saying. Go ahead.
Yeah, maybe Yambag's got no comment. DJ, how about your pick, Viper? What are your thoughts on Viper?
I played with Viper a couple games earlier when Daly and I had a scouting lobby going, and he seemed to mesh well. He moved the puck well. He was a good forward. He picked up a couple loose pucks, and he was playing well. So I think he'll do well.
Yeah, maybe you want to give us a bit of insight on your pick for Hugh Laurie.
Hugh Laurie late in the second round is pretty good in my book.
Yeah, except for that sketchy fucking sign up. Very image like
it. It's Hugh. He's greasy. What do you want?
So we now have Sober making a pick. You know what I mean? But I unfortunately don't know this individual. I was out season one, so I don't know much about him. But does anybody have any insight on this individual?
I don't know a lot about him.
I don't know
who he is.
Anybody else? Flanny's recruits.
Maybe some dude from Minnesota. Who the hell knows? I never heard of that dude in my life, man. Maybe it's a girl, too. Maybe it's a tranny or something. Who knows, man? We don't care. The only thing about this league, all right, we're trying to make hockey great again. We're an anti-douchebag league. That's it. We don't care if you're gay. We don't care if you're blue. We don't care if you're yellow belly. It doesn't even freaking matter over here. We are anti-douchebags, man. That's all. It's simple, man, all right? We're here. We're here to have a good time. We know you've been getting ripped off. We know you've been disenfranchised. This is why 239 Hockey is over here. 37. How has this draft been going on thus far? He's on mute.
What was that,
too? I don't know what's wrong with everybody's headsets, man. 37, did somebody else?
No,
what are your thoughts on the draft so far, bro?
Let me update some draft picks, though, first, just so we make sure we're keeping pace with this. So after Sober, Magilla, OG picked Shorty for Days, and then our illustrious panel host here picked BC Renton and Edge. So 37, you can give it. A little response to the question, and then we can get some more insight on the picks.
I didn't hear what he said. My phone's lagging up here.
Well, I was asking, what are your thoughts of the draft thus far, bro?
So far, it's going pretty much as scheduled here. You should see a nice little run on goalies shortly. You got everybody taking their stud forwards and a couple of quality. So I'm thinking time where some goalies should start jumping off the board.
Yeah.
Daly,
yeah,
I mean, you. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Nah, you first, bro.
I was going to say, Daly, do you want to give us an unbiased opinion on the last two picks by your fellow captains? DJ making a pick with BC Renton and Edge and Megs with Shorty for Days?
Well, here's the thing. I mean, no offense to Deej. I think there's a couple guys, and no offense to Edge and Grant, I think there's a couple guys on the board that I may have made mention to that might have been a little bit more fitting for DJ's team. But, again, chemistry is such a big thing. So, you know, it all depends. He might know something I don't. But from an actual skill set, there's some names on this list that I see that I probably would have taken before both those guys. But, again, we all value guys differently and what they do. So, again, I'll leave it at that. I don't really question the picks. It's the mid rounds. You're taking a lot of not chances, but everybody values guys differently. So I don't hate the picks, but I do see a couple names that I personally would have taken before then. But that doesn't mean they're bad picks. There's just a couple guys that maybe fit my style a bit more that I would have taken.
This is what Daly's gonna do. He's gonna pick all these other part-time players, and then he's gonna load up his team with like 10 guys that he's going to draft, and 5 of them are going to be part-time players, man. Well, that is going to be calling for some waivers and stuff, man.
No.
So that's what's been going on. But some dude, Sober's picking up this guy, Lemieux. He sounds familiar, man. But, I mean, it could be – I mean, I've known like 3 different Lemieux, man. So I don't know if it's – I don't know which one it is. He picked up this guy, Esoteric. That sounds like it's a spice or something like that, you know, like red hot peppers.
That's one of his boys.
One of his boys he brought over here.
Well, okay, so it's going to be Daly's Ringers. Is that what it's going to be, Daly?
Yeah, that, you basically changed the name of that.
Well, let's not lose sight of the fact that Mags made a pick for Cosmic Fade, which I believe is one of the Rookie of the Year candidates for the awards, which
he's on, phenomenal forward.
Checked on his stats before we went on, and he seemed like he did quite well last year. Put up some big goals and some big points. Here we have Lemieux, as Giant mentioned, esoteric, and now Yam has picked the Dynasty. Want to give us a quick rundown on that, Yam?
I'm pretty sure he's played goalie with us before with Daly, so I think he was good, but if not, he's got four positions preferred, so he'll play somewhere.
Find some ice time for him somewhere.
Ice time for everybody.
Shout out to the captains for moving this draft along real quick. People are coming in here prepared. Nice to see.
Yeah, there's no question about that. I completely agree with you over there, AC. And it looks like they're blacking out the picks over here on those that have been picked thus far. So you take a look at some of the gamer, some of the people that are still out there. You're still out there, AC. Preferred right wing, left wing. So just so the other captains are aware of that.
I'm a late rounder. Always been. That's where I fit well.
All right, we got this dude, Agent 007, man. That name sounds pretty badass. Shout out to Colinelli. I think he was a captain last season as well. Crazy Yeti Killer confirmed. He is not going to South Miami. He is going to Southwest Florida. So shout out to Crazy Yeti Killer. I am going to confirm that he is probably in the later rounds, and no, he is not a cancer like some of the players were last season. So that's good. This drug monkey RX, bro. Yeah, bro, you're going to be tripping balls, popping those pills, bro. I mean, that gamer tag is hilarious. And, I mean, I just love some of these. Dunker of FUD. So I think that's Duff backwards. I think that has something to do with alcohol. That might be an issue over there. Johnny Blaze is over here. Shout out to Johnny Blaze. Shout out to Jets Killer. I Run on Beer. These are names that I haven't seen or heard of in years. I'm pretty excited. And look at this over here, guys. Hasn't been picked up yet. Anybody, McSwagger over here, tremendous player. He cried a lot back in the day, but our team sucked really bad. But the guy is fantastic. If he gets a rhythm with your team, the guy is hard to stop, man. He had his own promotional video. McSwagger is no joke over here. He had some psychological issues back then, I believe. So hopefully he's taking care of them at this point. And welcome to the league, man. Really pumped up for you. Season number two over here. Plenty of picks over here, DJ. Would you agree with that? Plenty of leftover, plenty of picks over here. Still available.
Oh yeah, I still think there's some good middle round talent here that hasn't been picked up yet. A couple guys that were playing in the league last season, a couple new faces as well in here. Yeah, I'm going down the draft sheet and I still see a couple familiar names in here as well as like I said, some of the newer guys that have shown some talent in the scouting lobbies from what I've played with and what I've heard. So we'll see how it goes.
So just a quick update on some picks. We have Cujo picking Stoy Jopa, which is also a well-known vet from many leagues past. Good, decent pick. And Cameron picks Zelo, or now is Cameron. Fuck, this guy changes his gamer tag like every second day. Now it's shock. But Zelo, again, another vet to this e-gaming and hockey league hockey stuff. So a lot of vets being picked. That's good to see. And then Sabby picks Not Drug Monkey. Go ahead, sorry. 37.
Zlo also has a cup under his belt, season zero.
Yeah, with DMart, he was on that cup team.
Oh, yeah. And then we have Dale's picking Colinelli. Again, another big vet, big D. Sabby picked Drug Monkey. I don't know this guy at all. I apologize. So I don't know if anybody has any insight on him.
And another daily over from one of the other leagues there.
Yeah, no, he's an elite right D. It's a good value at that spot. So he wasn't on my board because we play a safe position. But yeah, he's a good player. So
and here it is.
And we have Giant
Jim
Colin
Flanagan just picking up the swagger over here. So Jim Flanagan picking it up with the retro gamer tags with the retro crew over here. Cause Renegade in the first round. I mean, he picked up Chubbs. These names, these guys are known entities. They're not non-entities. These are known entities. You guys hear these? Some dude named Drug Monkey.
He's got his member in his hand right now.
At this point. Some dude's name is Drug Monkey, and according to Daily, who likes the Big D, he's saying that Drug Monkey is a good value. Now Flanny is a genius, so that's why he picks McSwagger over here at the end of the third round. Outstanding value. I'm pumped up for this guy. I think things are going to be happening for Flanny over here. Yam, what are your thoughts so far on the draft?
Yam just took off.
Oh, he just took off again. What a surprise. I'm not even going to call on that guy anymore.
I'm here.
Yeah.
I'm here. Go refill his douche flute.
McSwagger was on my draft board. I was going to take him the next round if he was still there, but he got picked up. So he actually wanted to play goalie, but he failed on his sign-up sheet, so he's stuck playing forward, I guess. But he's still a good forward.
Got to check those rules, man.
Yeah.
Well,
if you sign up and you don't put anything as willing preferred, it will be refused.
Automatically.
Keep that in mind to the players.
Yep.
Yeah, and I mean, they send these mass emails out to make sure you check, take a look at the draft pool to make sure that all the available positions that you want to be able to do are available. So that's what's so interesting.
He does have emergency goalie on there as checked off, but yeah, if he wanted to play goalie, he should have let someone know. You know, I want to take this.
What the hell does emergency goalie mean?
In the rare case that you don't have a goalie available, you can use him for six games, I believe it is. Three or six games?
Yeah, six games a season maximum.
Playoffs too? That includes the playoffs?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, you have six games all together.
So Sniper's made a pick for Duff McGriff and Matt Davin. So Duff McGriff is also a.k.a. Tom 14-0-something-72. He's a guy we've played with quite a bit in some other leagues. Good, solid defenseman. Haven't seen him playing in leagues in a while. It's good to see him back. Matt Davin, don't know much about him, unfortunately. I don't know if anyone else on the panel can
provide a little bit of insight. Yeah, he's another Flanny recruit.
Is a Flanny recruit, you said?
Flanny recruit?
I believe so.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Okay.
And we're waiting on Savvy.
Savvy's at number 33 here, waiting on him.
I just want to add quick, Flanny, amazing job with the recruiting. We haven't had any issues with anybody he's recruited so far. So good job. Keep it up, buddy.
Yeah, definitely. It's nice to have recruiting coming in without having to roll 90 people coming in each season. You know what I mean? It's good to have the league grow like this.
Okay, so there's still a bunch of part-time players.
There goes AC off the board.
AC
is off the board.
Nice,
taking number 33 all overall.
Just happy to be picked. Okay. Glad to be associated with the team and do what I can.
Yeah,
that's a hookup from season two, isn't it?
So right, 37?
Yeah, that was
a hookup from season zero.
Yes,
the brutal cyclone season, unfortunately. But yeah, that was
the infamous cyclones.
Yeah. That was fun at the end of the day. That's what matters, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and very interesting so far. There's still a bunch of part-time players over here, guys. Bonniewood is over here. Dominator Silva, Goofy J91, Fallen Warrior. These guys are part times over here. Fiend is Rising, Jibo 2K. A lot of these guys are still available. Maybe they'll be getting picked up in the later rounds. Some of the notations over here, especially this Kristoff 18 dude. Mondays and Thursdays, first Wednesday of each month. First and third Wednesday. I mean, why did this guy even sign up? Who the hell is this?
I know Dale's has his eyes on him.
Christ tap? Well, what's going on with this dude, man?
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing that guys got to realize, man. When your availability looks like Hugh Laurie's and you put shit like that, like captains immediately throw their hands up, especially if, you know, you're a team that's drafting a lot of part-time players. You got to be really cautious because now all of a sudden you're missing a ton of time. You have to, you know, you're – as soon as you put specific dates and this and that, now you have a couple weekends and there's only two series a week. I mean, it starts to add up. So Guys, I know myself, I see that, and even if you're a good player, I might just kind of skim right over that, hence why Hugh Laurie fell the ball bag in the round two. You know, when you got all that stuff on there, it's a bit rough. So, again, we appreciate the honesty, but it is going to hurt your draft stock just because, again, you know, it's a lot of extra work for a captain.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we're waiting on Cujo right now.
He's probably smoking one up for Giant 918 right now.
Probably. I wouldn't doubt that.
Thanks, pal. Yeah, do that for me, man, because I'm good with that nowadays, man. The Dynasty is – this guy's saying schedule is looking pretty open for the time being. What are these guys? Are they trying to write a fucking novel over here or something like that? Jesus Christ, man. Dude, that is so vague. Oh, I'm looking for a job. Yeah, pal. You ain't the only one. Believe me, all right, buddy? What is that shit? What do you do? What do you do that you can't play at night? That is the most sketchy availability I've ever seen, dude. I mean, are these guys trying to get drafted at a later point? And this is one of Yambag's first picks, dude. So just the fact that you have something written like this. And then Hugh Laurie over here, I mean, I just don't understand it, dude. Possibly 329. You see, he's got dates over here. 4-2, 4-9, 4-16, 4-23. I mean, this is insanity how many days these guys are out over here. So I know Hugh Laurie. I think he's going on a cruise, I believe. I'm not positive about that. McSwagger's
out. Yeah,
he's
got some sort of tennis stuff coming up.
Yeah, that sounds really fake, but okay. but, like, see, you got guys like – Edge, who's got one day possibly missing. That's it. And there's obviously stuff that you can't control. You know what I'm saying? But that's the whole purpose of known MIA days. And I mean, for guys that are going to be out that much like Hugh Laurie, why wouldn't he just be a part-time in the first place? That's insanity. So I'm available on almost any night except for Wednesdays. This also depends on game time. Okay.
We got a pick here, Giant.
Esotetric, what does he have? Fucking season tickets to somebody? I mean, come on. If I have
picking. No, it says it right there. He's got a bowling league. So sometimes I'm going to refuse Wednesdays anyway, so it doesn't matter. But, yeah, he's got a bowling league, so he might not make it in time. But it says it right in the sign-up.
Oh, that's awesome, bro.
Yeah, so I'm going to refuse Wednesdays.
Oh, I got mad respect for dudes who play bowling, dude. That's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. We got another pick here, Giant. We got Cujo taking Crazy Yeti Killer, 35 overall.
Yeah, how was that bong hit, Cujo? Did you make the right hit?
God, oh there's my some God, really, you picked Yeti?
I don't know about
still,
that,
man.
Bro.
Yeah, there's still some names on the board here that I'm surprised haven't gone yet. Yeah, so yeah, we're done yet, man.
Cujo, you got to chill out with those bong hits, bro. I don't know about that pick, dude.
Yo, you got Running Duck Butter, who honestly – if his availability was a little bit better this season, probably would have been a top two-round pick.
Absolutely.
Nick DeGreek's a super solid left wing. I don't know who's in need of forwards right now. I played in another league with him. He's solid as hell. Johnny Blaze was a cup last year. You know, there's some names that are sticking out. Dusty Wright Stick is another guy. He's a really solid defensive centerman. He plays a really good two-way game. He's not drafted. We played in a game against Eagle 1170 the other night. He's solid as hell. Desired Customs, he plays multiple positions. I played with him in another league. He's solid as hell. I mean, there's some really, really, really good names still out there that you know, that I see. So there's a lot for these captains to pick from. So we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you, Daly. I do not disagree with you. Bunch of names out there.
Oh, and right on cue, Yam takes Dusty. Right on cue. There it goes. Off the board.
Greasiness.
So
I mentioned him, so he got worried.
So I don't know if this is a mistake on the draft order, but are we showing that DJ was up at number 37?
Yeah, now Sober fucked up there. Sober's picking after me there.
Wow. Sober,
no, that was Savvy that screwed it up.
Yeah, sorry. Savvy fucked it up.
Savvy should lose his pick.
So we got –
so hold on. Did
everybody's
– wait,
DJ didn't get
then?
The pick yet, though.
No, I see my pick's out there, yeah.
Oh, sorry. My bad.
Dunker of Fud. He's a personal friend of mine. Played with him for a while now, and he's pretty solid. He can play a lot of positions, so I think he'll fit well for me.
Nice. Okay, cool. Johnny Blaze just went. I mean, that was a matter of time, too. He plays at pretty much every position, so that's nice. We're getting down to the wire here. I want to see some of these part-time players go, man. I know that's where I'm looking right now. So,
yeah, this should be about the point where part-time guys start flying here.
Yeah, that's the pick. I mean, we got, 10 more picks left here, whatever it is?
And there's not a lot of goalies that we're taking so far here either. I'm surprised by that.
It makes me wonder, are the other positions that thin that people are picking that?
There it goes. You listen, DJ. That's a good point right there.
I had to listen. You got me one.
Man. Yeah, he's a goal scorer. Yeah, no, he's solid as hell. So, again, like I said, I know him and Viper primarily are both left wingers, but I do think Nick's a little bit more flexible as well as Viper, so DJ's got a little bit of flexibility as far as what he can do. Offensively, so I like both picks. I know their best positions are each left wing.
Back here, please.
He's got a little flexibility, so that's a nice pick by DJ there. And that leaves Flanny for 41. Who's he taking here, Giant? What does he need? What are you thinking here? Mr. Hollywood's having a good draft, so what do you think's next?
I think he's going to pick up Saint or something like that. He needs to build a wall in front of him. That's what he needs to do. He's sick and tired of getting ripped off. He needs to build the wall. I don't know who's going to pay for it. I think he's going to pick up a defensive guy over here. But wait a minute. He's a refused left defense, so I apologize over that. See, running duck putter is just such a terrible, terrible schedule. I don't even know how the board of directors even let him sign up. Those are terrible days to be out. He's going to be out forever and ever, it looks like. He's out today, tomorrow. 16th to 19th.
Some of those are weekends. Yeah, he just put weekends. All MIA dates. Yeah, okay. So some of those are weekends.
So I don't know how this dude Pale Poner is, man, but I haven't played with him in years, so I don't know how he is. I think there are plenty of defensive guys over here that are there are plenty of days over here. And we got Jimbo 2K. He's got right D preferred. He's willing to play anything. And he's saying he's off on most Mondays, but are games played on Mondays or no? Mondays?
Yeah, there's a lot of games on Mondays. Sundays seem to be the off day, right?
Yeah, I thought Tuesdays and Thursdays were the most popular days for games.
Oh, the Flyers lost to you.
So there was a comment by Yam in the chat, and I noticed this name when I was looking at some stuff before the show, Cody. This guy was top 10 in scoring, as yet to be
picked. He just got picked up right now.
There you go. I was going to say, that's a shock to someone that was top 10 in scoring in season one and has not been picked yet. That didn't make much sense.
Yeah, and then I'm looking down at these part-times. There's some good part-times. You said Jimbo. Dominator Silva's still on that list.
Yep.
And he plays pretty much freaking everything. Goofy J. Problem is Goofy can only play Mondays. You have Fallen, who's part-time. He was the leading goal scorer last year. Everybody, we're talking about him. Phoenix Rising's a really good lefty, right? Yeah, I played with him a bunch last year. He was on my team. So that's another guy that's available. There's a ton of good players still out there. And again, I mean, you're looking at this part-time stuff. I mean, you need these guys. You need part-time players. So, assuming we're going to see a bunch go right here. And there you go. There goes Dom. All right. Well, I got to make my pick. Taking all the way. That's my starting goaltender right there, too, and at pick number 44. So I'm feeling good about that.
Meg's picking up the Pale Poner. Does anybody know that guy?
Yeah, I haven't played with him in years, though, so I don't know much about – I don't remember much from him. But can somebody tell me from the board of directors why the hell the reference information is over here on the draft sheet? Does anybody give a crap if Sober Enough or Drug Monkey or Xbox message from Jim Flanagan, is that relevant on the draft sheet?
Think about it like this, Giant. Let's say you don't know a new name, okay, and you see, referred by Daly. You say, Daly's a pretty good player. I'm going to assume that guy is probably not fucking terrible.
Daly doesn't know bad players.
I'm just saying.
Daly doesn't know bad players. You know me, bitch. That's good enough, man. So,
what, I also think there's a component of making sure that you've got someone that's giving you a good reference. So you're going to assume, you know, for example, if Yam or someone makes a recommendation to the league, you're not going to get a douchebag. Right.
Well, and here's another thing too. You know, it's for those guys as well. You know, if you're in the draft and then all of a sudden you see, oh shit, like my name's kind of attached to Daly. So everything that I do is in a certain way going to be a reflection of him as well. And I think that's big for a guy to know, like, hey, listen, this shit's out in the open. Like all that referral stuff that we do when you sign up and you get into the league, that means something. Like your name, like every guy that I brought in, his name's attached to mine. So if any one of those guys ends up being a douchebag, like that falls on me. That makes me look bad. Like who the fuck are you bringing in the league? So again, I think it's an accountability from the player standpoint. I do think it's relevant. I think it's good for everybody to see that. You know, again, I think it's only going to be better for the league in the long run. So that's my 2 cents.
When some of them don't even have any kind of reference information over here, you know, dad, I'm not your dad, USMC, a.k.a. Mopar WK, a.k.a. Vladimir Putin's second best friend. I mean, this guy, his reference is a prostitute in Seoul, South Korea. I mean, I don't understand. I mean,
you ever dealt with one of those?
Does a massage parlor count?
Must be one hell of a good massage.
Oh, man.
So we got Yam making a pick for Desired Customs. Yeah, and what's your thought on that pick?
I heard he was good, and he plays defense, and I needed a D-man. So hopefully he's good or he's on the trade block.
Jesus. Isn't it great how much fucking research Yam does for these things? Well, he plays defense, so I'm hoping it really works out, and we'll just call it a day.
Well, he spent the last week in Florida Facebook Live and stuff.
Yeah.
Banging his asshole.
Thanks for everybody
which
who voted
on a poll that is gay.
Live is, confirmed gay at all times.
All right, so I just want to give this shout-out to Agent from Jim Flanagan. So shout-out to Agent Flanagan. Just wanted to give you a shout-out.
And he was just
here,
picked.
So just really pumped up over here. Season
the magic voice over
draft.
Here. He mentioned somebody in their take it instantly.
Yeah. Yeah, he just got picked up by Cracker, Cujo.
Oh, did he? Yeah, whatever. I mean, these messages come across my screen, and I'm just giving the shout-outs over here, man. So, Crazy Yeti Killer is predicting that he will be Rookie of the Year, season number 2. I have a hard time believing that. I think that it's more true that Al Gorleone founded the internet than it is that Crazy Yeti Killer is going to win Rookie of the Year. What do you think, Daly?
Oh, man. No, I mean, he can play a little bit. But, there's a lot of good players coming in, man. There's a lot of rookies. There's a lot of hype guys. You got Light the Lamp. You got Chew Therapy's a rookie this year. Esoteric. Those are a couple guys on my team. Dynasty. There's so many good freaking players. I don't think Crazy Eddie finished the top 5 in voting, but that's just my opinion, so we'll see what happens. But I'm taking nothing away from Crazy, but there's just a lot of good talent in this pool this year. There's a ton of it, so we'll see what happens, though.
So we got Shock taking Arbelberry, 385.
It's a D-man.
And then Sabby taking I Run on Beer, and Sniper taking Eagle 1170.
Yeah, Eagle was on my team last year. That's a good quality pickup right there.
Yeah, we got one more Flanny pick here, and then from here on out, it's all optional picks for captains.
Hey, DJ, what's max roster we can take?
I think it goes up to 7 plus the captain, so 8, if I recall. Yeah, so 8 total, including yourself.
Okay.
Yo, 37. Are you in the draft?
No, I am taking the season off.
Roger that. All right, because I was like, where are you, bro?
Yeah, I'm taking the season off with my newborn. He's not quite on our schedule yet. So instead of risking a captain taking a pick on me or taking part-time, which who's going to want to take a part-time goalie? I just figured I'd take this season off, let him get situated, and then we'll go on from there.
Yeah, congrats on the new addition to the family.
Thank you, sir.
Some of these kids never get their fucking schedule right. So Good luck with that, dude, because
yeah,
that's just the way it be, yo. But anyway, still a bunch of over here. Donnywood, Gucci, Fallen Warrior.
Two brothers
over here, man. So very interesting, Goofy and Fallen Warrior.
We've got Phoenix Rising and Jimbo going 50-51 to Hollywood.
Oh, there's his back end right there.
Yep,
Phoenix part-time with Jimbo.
Yeah, Phoenix is part time as well this season. I know Phoenix is very, very active on the forums and on the site and Facebook and everything. So good to see him get drafted. And I mean, everybody knows Jimbo here, so I think that's another good pick, even though it's part time. He's still a pretty good player.
And Sniper picked Valcor, another well-known vet, part-time, but still very good, solid player.
Okay, so...
And Savvy took Donnywood, another part-time player.
Yeah, I mean, this is pretty much it. I mean, the draft is pretty much wrapped up. They're just drafting some leftovers at this particular point. You're saying the sixth round, seventh round is optional. The fact of the matter is that there just isn't that much players anymore left on the draft board. So shout out to all these guys over here and girls and straight people, heterosexuals, homosexuals. And
I'm not sure LGBTQ we have any females members. Playing with us anymore.
It doesn't matter. So maybe they act like it or whatever. LGBTQ. So shout out to all the players over here. It's a really exciting time over here. You guys know where it's at. You know we're making hockey great again. This is where it's at 239 Hockey. So we'll have in the coming days, we'll go over the analysis of these teams and stuff. So you guys know where you get the best media analysis over here, over at 239 Hockey. So they haven't put all the teams together. They haven't separated them by captains, unless I'm looking at the wrong list over here.
No, that's not.
Captains,
yeah, that's not. Here. That's not done yet. That's that'll get done after the draft. It's too hectic to try and do it right now while everybody's still drafting.
Okay.
So I'll see if I can get someone on that now.
Jaeger bombs. Oh, that's an awesome name.
Yeah,
I haven't had that since I was like 25 years old.
Still in prime time here. I'm only 22 here, Giant.
Nice, bro. Jaeger bombs.
We got Cujo up next, waiting on him to take his first optional pick here.
While we're waiting, I want everybody to give me one pick that they feel either was a steal or just not a great pick. Anything that sticks out just one way or the other. Start with you, DJ.
I'm not sure. Nothing against Thug. He's a great goalie and all, but I don't know if he's number two overall here. I think he could have definitely gone later in the draft, and Mags could have picked up somebody a little more offensive presence. Thug's a solid goalie, but goalies aren't going to always win games in this. Everybody here has been EA'd before. We all know the feeling. It's just the way the game works, unfortunately. And I think he could have gone a little bit later in the draft, and Max could have picked someone else up earlier here.
Jaya, what's your one pick that sticks out in your mind, good or bad?
Me?
That's Jaya, but that's.
I'm sorry, dude. I thought you said Yambag. I'm sorry, dude.
No worries.
Yo, so listen, Yambag picking up Hugh Laurie at 16 overall with the schedule that this guy's got. I mean, that's almost retarded. So I'm not going to say it really is retarded, but it's borderline retarded. That is one of the most horrific schedules for someone to be full-time. And it's kind of selfish, man, to even put yourself as full-time when you got such a whack-ass schedule like that. Anymore,
yeah, you take
any more fucking days off. It makes almost no sense to me, AC. And I don't know if that's going to pay off for Yam. I think there are a lot more better players at that particular point in time. Edge was over there. BC Renton was over there. So, he's picking up Hugh Laurie, dude. I just don't know if it's going to work out. Yeah, it's cute to practice and stuff like that. It's cool if he's going to be around to practice. But if he ain't there for the games, come on, bro. That's all I got to say about that, AC.
Good. Good analysis.
Yeah, pick.
Yeah. What's your one pick, good or bad?
I'm going to say Yeti because I took Dusty right after him, and Dusty was like a second-round player. Like, I was going to take him in the second round, and he just kind of fell to the fourth round. If Dusty wasn't there, I was going to take Cody. I think the best pick, one of the best picks is Cody because that kid was a beast, man. Like, to be honest with you, I like to play with different guys, and that's, like, probably the only reason why I didn't take Cody, but Cody going where he went, like, where the hell did he even go? Like, the fifth round or some shit? Like, he went way too low.
Yeah. He scored, first pick of the fifth round of planning.
He scores a lot of points, and I think he's new to, like, league play. And, like, it was, like, his first season. He's going to – I think Cody's going to wind up being, like a Cam IM type player at some point. And he went way too low.
I think he was a product of the system he played in. He was playing with Chubb and Steve, man. You're talking about two elite guys who obviously still have it. When you play all your games with those guys, it's hard for me to really validate the numbers. It's just like Fallen playing with DeMar and NJ Ski. You know, again, would Fallen do that in another system? I don't know. Probably not.
Yeah, but I get that.
That's kind of where I'm at.
I get that, but like when you play with Cody, like he was a guy like you weren't afraid when he got the puck. Like some guys, like some third forwards, you're afraid when they get the puck they're going to turn it over. But he always made pretty smart plays, and the thing is, he didn't take any really many penalties at all. Like, if he's on the ice, then that's a good thing. If you got guys that take penalties, like I used to take penalties by the boatload back in the day, and it was terrible.
Back but in like, the day,
or was that last year?
Right? Yeah, it's your pick, dude.
Wait, not you, man.
The draft.
Somebody, relax. The thing is with Cody is that he'll do whatever you tell him to do. Like he's totally open to criticism, and you don't find a lot of guys that like. You can just say, hey, don't do that. It sucks. And they're like, all right, cool. I won't do that anymore. Like, he's always active. Like, he's a great teammate. And I'm going to take Fuller. I'm taking that fat fucking Fuller.
So when you told him to finger bang your ass, he did it? Is that what you're telling me right now?
He did, yeah. He did whatever he needed to do for the team. And he was great.
Cody, if I would have known that, you would have been on my team, boy.
All right, Daly, what's your good pick? Or, sorry, pick good or bad?
Oh, man. Bad pick. I already touched on Thug. I'll pick someone else. Giant already talked on Ed. It's not a shot at Ed. I just think it was too early. Mopark. I think Gunny, again, I'm going to go with the product of the system. Thank you. I think that him going in the second round, third round, you saw some names going behind him. I got Colinelli after Gunny, and it's not a shot at Gunny at all, but I really do think he was a product of the system he played in last year. Not to take anything away, but we'll see if he can do it this year because he's going to be the anchor on a defense this year, and I question whether or not he can handle it, but I hope he proves me wrong. So I would say maybe Mopark. I think he went like 22, 23, something like that, when you could have got Colinelli, who I think is more of a staple on D.I. I ended up getting him at 29.
Gunny went 15.
He went 15.
Oh, so even more of a stretch. I mean, Colinelli at 29, Gunny at 15. I could have easily seen them being flip-flopped. But again, you know, we all value players differently. So, again, much love for Gunny. He knows I love him. But that would just be my maybe stretch a little too far on that one.
Dale's here.
Dale's on the clock, buddy.
Oh, all right, cool.
37, what's your pick, good or bad?
I kind of like the Cosmic Fade pick at 22. He's a solid player. He's there for the garbage goals when you need him. Touching on what everybody else said, no offense to Thug at all, taking number 2 overall. That's a bit of a stretch. It depends on how Megillah works his team.
And just reiterate, it's any goalie at 2. It's not just
yes. It's the position.
All right. For me, my pick, a couple of picks I was thinking I'd already been taking, but I think overall for me, the steal of the draft is McSwagger. Picked where he was. I've played with him recently in this new version of the game. I think he's going to shock a lot of people coming back into this. And I think he's going to be a big part of the offense for Hollywood. I think that's a really good pick at 30.
He's got what? Renegade, Chubbs, McSwagger, Cody, Phoenix, Jimbo. That's a pretty solid team he's got in front of him. He's probably playing net there.
All right, we got Daly taking Fallen here. So I guess you're bringing him into your system to see how he works there, Daly. Or a lot of shit talking from last season here.
Well, you know, you got to look at it like this. I probably, like I said, I think he's a great, he'll be good as a third forward. He's going to fit in. He's going to be playing with some really skilled players. And I think that last year he really excelled in the playoffs and getting in front of the net. I know in our series, in the four games I played, he had like 3 tip-in goals. And that I remember. So I think he could be a real nice play. Also, he's played with Dan for a whole season. And I put a lot of stake in drafting Dan where I did. So I think it only makes sense to surround him with players that he's familiar with. I think that NJ Ski was a good player, but I think that Chew Therapy is a better player. So with that being said, I think Dan has upgraded in the middle, and I think Fallen and Esoteric will fill in nicely. Me and Colinelli aren't going to be missing any series on D. And then all the ways going to be playing that. I love my team, but I knew I was going to love my team before I drafted my team. Because it didn't matter. I just knew. But yeah, I'm ready to go. We're ready to go. Fallen's on the squad now. Welcome. I got one more pick I want to make too. So I think we're running out of guys, though, to be completely honest.
Like, we got to left on this. Sober up next here. We're waiting on.
Like, I mean, I think this is great because this just tells me that, like, from an admin standpoint, like, we did the right thing. It seemed like we cut it off right at the right moment. It seems like every single player who's in this draft pool is going to get drafted and be placed on a team, which is big. I think that's huge. There's only a couple full-time players that are probably going to end up being part-time players. But again, we'll see how it goes. So, like I said, kudos to all the admins because I said I think we cut it off right at the right time to where everyone's going to get drafted, which is great. That's what you want to see. No one's going to be sitting out. So
we got Sober picking that one odd guy. And we covered off Yam picking Legion, right?
Yep, that's done.
Yeah, that would happen.
Yeah, I mean, AC, I think we can wrap this up, man, because, I mean, the rest of the guys, this is like fodder. Like, they'll be playing, but periodically and stuff like that. Up to you guys. I think I'm going to get out of here, but
may as well see this out. I mean, there's only a couple picks left, only a couple more guys. Yeah, just can't take too much longer here.
So I just want to thank everybody involved. I want to thank the players. I want to thank all the fans. You know, everybody's doing a tremendous job. Shout out to the board of directors as well, doing a fabulous job over here at 239 Hockey. I mean, that's all I got over here. Anything over there from UAC? You guys going to stay on or what?
Yeah, I'll ride this out. Let's see, just let the last couple picks happen.
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, sounds good, fellas. I just want to give everybody a shout out. Continue to check us out, www.239hockey.net. Follow us on Twitter, at 239hockey, Giant918, signing out. I'll see you guys later this week, early next week. Good night, everybody.
Later, Giant.
Thanks,
later,
Giant. Always appreciate
it. I mean, so you're looking at this. There's still some names out there. There's some Jets killers, Mr. Reliable back there. He plays pretty much everything besides goalie. So, again, he signed up full-time. He'll probably slide into a part-time role, but I doubt that he won't be drafted at some point and end up on a team. Marine Mike, he plays four positions. Hey, there's a weird thing on his draft. He's willing lefty, but it also has refused lefty, so I don't know what happened there.
Who was that?
Marine Mike.
We'll look back through his sign up and just confirm everything. That may have just been a typo here.
Yeah, and I'm sure it is, so there's that. But, yeah, man, this, like I said, I touched on it. This is great. Like, it looks like everyone's going to get pretty much on a team, and then you'll probably have a couple waivers, and that'll be it, you know, and we'll get
it. Yeah, there's only, I think, 2 or 3 players that are strictly waivers. It looks like we're not going to have anybody undrafted here unless people start opting out of their 7th picks.
Oh, fuck. I was going to take Saint. That's twice now. You sharked me, by the way.
You fucked me before the draft even started, bud. I don't want to hear it.
Saint's a great pick. I'm surprised he didn't get...
I don't know how he went this long, but I was hoping nobody grabbed him before he could pick him up. But I was surprised he went this long, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, I like the pick. I was, like I said, I was going to grab Saint there, too. I got a couple part-time players on my team. So, you know, again, just because... You got the full – everybody's going to play for the most part. Like I said, some guys opt to just draft the 6. I'm not a fan of that. You know, I'm all for, you know, being able to create some jobs, create some opportunities for players, and you know, when you do, that's why the part-time thing for me, I think is great, because you're creating another series for somebody else. Even if it's at part-time, you're giving somebody an opportunity to showcase their skills. You're giving somebody who maybe wouldn't have had a chance to, you know, in another league, an opportunity to play at least once a week. I mean, we only play twice a week, so full-time to part-time isn't really different, you know, too different. So, and any sort of exposure that you can get, especially for a new guy, I mean, you might draft somebody you never heard of. I never played with Mighty Ice 88 before.
That's who I'm taking.
Oh, okay, so here, you know, but he's got center goalie, so if he's playing one series a week, all of a sudden he's stealing games for you in net, you're like, holy shit, like, look at this value.
Not exactly.
I mean, it could be a bust, but
it could be, but it's, you know, it's my final pick of the draft overall here. It's you know, one, it's not a necessity to take, but may as well add somebody else to the roster, and worst case scenario, you know, he's a decent player and gets a good trade value.
Yeah, and what you're doing, too, is you're taking a little bit off of the waiver system as well. I mean, again, the waiver system's great. We're going to use it regardless. But you're taking a little bit off of that, too. It's a little bit off 37's plate. So again, you know, having a nice roster, creating some opportunities for players. He's like, yeah, well,
I'm not going to have a plate at this point.
Yeah, right. I'm making him hungry,
you
man.
Know, again, but here's the thing. The beauty of, man, is you know, hopefully now with all these new guys, the word's going to spread. We play 1 week. We play 2 weeks. There's buzz. You know, we're doing stuff on the site. We're putting up content. We're putting up our media. You know, we're doing, you know, write-ups. Everybody's contributing in that sense. All of a sudden, we get some traffic flow, and then we're going to get those sign-ups, and those guys are going to do the waivers. You know, that's what you're hoping for at this point. And getting ready for the – you know, those guys are trying to get ready for the next season. So, again, I think that I think we're, you know, in the right path here. So I love this. I think there's like five names on this list right now. I don't even know who I'm gonna take at this point. But Sober, hurry up. Okay, so DJ took him. Who did Sober take?
Sober was waiting for DJ to post because DJ hadn't posted.
Oh, okay. No, because DJ has two picks. No.
Yeah, no. I said Saint and Mighty Ice. I had 60-61.
Okay. So then.
Right. And then Mags peaced out.
Now? Yeah, Mags deferred. Okay, so Mags, yeah.
All right, so now Sober's on 63. Got it. Cool.
Yep. Then you'll be up next.
Yeah. I'll be honest. I think I'm going to take.
No, we're going to get an inside track here to Daly's pick here.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, right. He's kind of
like here. No, listen, here's my dilemma. Well, here's my dilemma right now is that I got DeMart on part-time. I'm pretty confident Colinelli's not missing any time. I shouldn't miss any time either. So I'm debating whether or not I want to back up our D or if I want to just solidify having another forward.
Yeah. Sober. So kind of where I'm at. Sober taking Goofy J here
for the one series a week.
He can only play Mondays. He can only play on Mondays. That's why he's – I mean, if he wasn't, he probably would have been on a squad. Gosh. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going on mute. Hold on. I'm trying to figure this out. Who thought round seven would be this rough?
Chris Tapp.
He's got great availability there.
We touched on that earlier. That's a really good
catch. Yeah, that unfortunately, like new player and all, that's nice to see you want to play, but with availability like that, it's going to be rough for any captain to try and pick you up. You play once in a blue moon, literally. It looks like.
Fuck. All right. I'm going to. I'll take this guy right here then. There you go.
Not a bad pick.
Yep, Jets killer.
Jets a solid defenseman.
Yeah, I mean, again, you know, you're looking at it like this. Sometimes with my job, I do get hung up at work, and I do run late. So, if that happens, I need to have another D-man. So, with Colinelli playing both sides and Jets preferring right D, I think it'll be a nice fit. I know he signed up full-time, but he'll most likely be part-time on the squad. So, we'll see. But, yeah, I think that's done. I think I'm done with my draft
now. That's round seven.
Yeah. Yeah, we got Yam.
Jets is not a bad pick, even if he's just a bench player. like you said, he could play right D if you can't make it. I mean, that's not a bad pick at all.
Jet's solid. I mean, he's the type of player that you shouldn't have any worries of putting him in. He's not an elite defenseman. I'm not going to, blow sunshine up his ass, but he you put him in a game and he's not going to be a detriment to you.
I feel, too, another thing is I really believe that people feed off one another. I really do. There's very few, D-men that I play with that you can't, adapt and, adjust. So, if he's in a situation where he's playing with me, maybe our styles mesh. He's, more defensive-minded, and I do a lot offensively. I think it might be a good mesh. Again, Colinelli's going to be eating up pretty much 99% of those minutes. But I'm hoping that maybe they could have some chemistry if there's a series I can't make or something like that. So, again, Jets is a vet. He's played the game a lot. I don't hate the pick. Again, the only difference is he was a full-time sign-up. He'll most likely be playing part-time for me. But, again, he gets to be on the villains, and, he's a villain in his own right. So it works out perfectly, really. Boys, I'm about to check out as well.
Yeah, we got the last two picks here. We got Sniper taking Nils, and Flandy's got one more pick, and that'll wrap everything up here. So let's see here. Yeah, Flandy's got one more pick here, and that'll wrap everything up. Oh, no, never mind. He deferred. That's it.
Yeah, he cut it.
All right, gentlemen, thank you so much for participating. I want to say thank you for letting me participate and take over for Hollywood. I'm sure he was missed, but I was glad to help out, glad to be part of this.
You see the chat here. Hollywood is saying he's taking Dale's season opener.
We already got the trips going.
I got him.
All right, boys. I think this is going to set up for the first series here with all the bad blood between the two of you.
Yeah, I think so.
Please. Hey, I know Hugh Laurie, if you're watching this, because you will at some point, just give me Hollywood Series 1, please, and let's just be done with it so I can end it right away. I've already got the write-up done. All I had to do was insert his players' names into my write-up.
So it's already done. You got the meme, too. That's got to be used here.
Oh, of course. I've already got people sending me memes. The Bill Cosby... Week one, baby. I'll see you at the Pudding Palace, dog.
Any closing comments, Yam?
Yeah, it was a good draft. Everybody drafted quick. There was no delays or any nonsense that went on or anything like that. So my team's already spamming me for him.
Little delays from Cujo.
So I'm ready to start playing hockey. I'm ready to back out of here.
DJ?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think... I think everybody drafted well. I think it'll be an interesting season. Nobody seemed to really take away, from the draft as the heavy favorites. I mean, Dale's going to say he's the favorite here, and, he's going to talk a lot of shit, but it is what it is. I think everybody's pretty even and on par here, and we'll see how it goes. Should be a good season.
37.
I just want to say thanks to all the captains. This the draft went only an hour, and that's with seven rounds here, 70 picks total. Good job on all of that, and let's get this season rolling.
All right, boys. Everyone involved in this league, good luck. Great job. Have a good season. Looking forward to seeing people on the ice. And we're out.
Later, boys.
Peace.